So this is the another problem. You have to be very careful. In this problem, you can see here, it is the typical another two beam section. In these two beams, so AB is a one beam and CD is another beam. In this, the AB, in the support B, it is a roller. Okay, A is a sub, which is a hinge support. You can see very clearly. And C is a roller, and B, this you should take it this one as a roller only. You should not take this one as a hinge. Okay, so there is a moment at where the moment will be acting, that will be shown in a dot. Okay, so here at a 1 meter, 3 kilonewton, which is acting in an anti-clockwise direction, and so D is a support of hinge. Okay, here also there is another moment, 4 kilonewton, which is acting at a distance of 2 meter from a support A at a clockwise direction. Okay, so what you have in the typical section, if you see this, so you should find first, you should come to your mind that first initiative only you have to take the topmost beam section AB, and you have to find out the reaction at B. Whatever the reaction at B will be, that will be equivalent to the load at this point. Okay, load at this point for a beam section CD. Okay, so you can see here, this one will be converted. The free body diagram will be written like this. Hinge to reaction will be there. The B here, there is only one reaction that will be taken. For the CD section, this has been taken as a CD. This B reaction, whatever it will be there, that will be taken as a load here. Okay, so this will be moment as it is, and D, there will be two reactions you have to take into consideration. One is horizontal, another one is horizontal, another is a vertical. Here also the same. This is the hinge. There you have to take two forces, AX and AY. Okay, so for take the first initially only the beam section, AB section. Okay, AB beam section, you take it. In this beam, in the AB beam section, what you have to do is unknown reactions you have to find it. So unknown reaction is AX, AY and RP. So these are the two, three unknown reactions. First initially, to nullify, to make it easy, you take moment at this only. So there is a three equilibrium equation. One is vertical force, summation of vertical force and horizontal force and moment. So in this, to make convenient, you take moment at A. So initially only you take the moment. Okay, if you take at moment, these two forces will be nullified. So then you left with only unknown, only one force. Okay, so take moment at A is equal to zero. Take moment at A is equal to zero. Anti-clockwise direction as positive. Here they have taken effects. I will come later. Okay, so take anti-clockwise direction as positive. So at 2A point. Okay, then you come one by one, 5 into distance, it is a clockwise direction, so it is negative. So next is 4 kilonewton, so as symbol shows, it is moving towards the clockwise direction, so you take -4. Okay, so next is 3 into distance of 3 plus 2, 5 into 3, it is moving in a clockwise, 5 into 3, it is clockwise, minus. Okay, so next with a reaction RB into a distance of 6 meter. Okay, that is moving in a anti-clockwise direction. This is the force, this is the beam. When force is acting, it will rotate in an anti-clockwise direction, so that it is a positive. So finally you calculate, finally you will get RB as 4 kilonewton. So reaction will be 4 kilonewton, the load will be 4 kilonewton, which is acting on the beam section CD. Okay, whatever the reaction you determine, 4 kilonewton, that is the load on the CD section. Okay, this is also reaction for the beam AB section, and the same value will be equivalent to the load for the CD beam. Okay, next you have to find out the horizontal force. You can see here the horizontal force here, the horizontal force, whatever you here, there is only one horizontal force. Summation of Fx is equal to zero. Moving towards the positive, or moving towards the right, you take it as positive. So AX is equal to zero. There is no other forces, so it will be zero. Okay, so you determine AX and you determine RP, only AY. Okay, take summation of vertical forces is equal to zero. Take vertical forces is equal to zero. So you can see here AY and RB, two forces will be there. It is moving towards the upward direction. Take AY and RB, two forces moving towards up. Okay, so it will be positive. So minus 5 and 3 kN, which is moving towards the downwards. So 5 and 3, it is moving towards down. So it will be both are negative. So after inserting the substituting the value of RB value, you finally will get the AY as 4 kN. So finally, the three forces, unknown forces in the beam AB, you have been determined. Okay, then you come for the CD section. In the CD section, so you know that D is a hinge. Take two forces DX and DX and DY. Okay, because due to hinge, there is two unknown forces. That's why. So DX and DY. Okay. So these are the two unknown. So what you do is better you take the moment at A. Okay. So here what you do is one horizontal forces is there. So finally sigma fx, you put sigma fx is equal to 0, dx is equal to 0, because only here dx, here it is only one force, so it's that's why dx is equal to 0. Okay, next you take moment at D is equal to 0. Okay, so they have taken moment at C. It is your convenient to take moment at D. Okay, take moment at D and find it. Okay, RC into distance of 6 meter. So it is moving towards the, here they have mentioned that the moment at C. So to our convenient, you can take moment at D as to make it easy. Okay, so two forces it will get nullified now, so that is better. But they have taken MC, moment at C is equal to 0, you take that one only, no problem. Okay, so DX, it will move towards this point only, so that's why it will become 0, because no distance will be there. So next you take dy into distance of 6 meter, so it rotate in the anti-clockwise direction, so that's why the dy into 6, it is a positive. Next is 3, so it is also moving towards the clockwise direction, so that's why 3 is also positive. Here 3 is also positive. Okay, next here another is RB. Okay, RB, it is rotate RB into 3 meter, so it is rotating in the clockwise, so that's why RB minus RB into 3, it is negative. Okay, so you know D only RB, you know the value of RB, that is you are already determined. RB value is 4 kN, insert the 4 kilo RB value as 4. Okay, and find out the DY value as 1.5. You got the values as DY as 1.5. okay, next is summation of, yeah, what is this? You have to find out, you have determined the DX, DY you have determined, only the RC you have not determined. So what you do is summation of vertical forces, if you use it, you can get it this one, because this is a vertical force. Okay, so summation of Fy is equal to 0, take it upward as positive direction. So RC and DY both are, RC and DY both are in upward direction. So here RC and DY both are positive. So here RB, it is moving towards the downwards, so that's why it is negative. Okay, so that one, if you insert the value of substitute the value of DY and RB value, then you can get the RC as 2.5, because RB, you know that is as a 4 kN you determined earlier, DY you have determined just, that is 1.5. so finally RC value will be 2.5. so this is how you have to be converted here. So I told only one important thing is the load, finding this load. So how to find out this magnitude of the triangular load is, what is this, is the half, the magnitude of the load will be half into base into 8. So you take the area of the right angle triangle, half base is, so base of the base is 3 meter. Okay, so base you take that one as 3 meter. Okay, height, what is the height? Height is, what is the load of the magnitude? So load of the magnitude is 2 will get cancelled. So finally you will get 3 kilonewton. So 3 kilonewton as, what is that? 3 kilonewton as concentrated load. Okay, so I told from this end it will be acting 2/3 and this it will be 1/3. Okay, if you take 2/3 from here, so 2/3 from 3 meter distance, so we'll get cancel 2 meter from here. Okay, so 2 meter, so finally whatever the distance here it is acting, so you can see here 2 meter from here, load moment will be at here, from here 1 meter, okay, no load will be there, so 1 meter here no load, from here it is at 2 meter, so how 2/3 into a distance of 3 meter, if you cancel that you'll get 2 meter, okay, so load will be 3 kilonewton. So this one you have to do initially only. Okay, sorry, I forgot to tell you at the beginning because I already told in the previous problems. So this you have to do this conversion. If you do this conversion, next it is very easy to calculate the rest of the things.